They slap their name on it. And it's why? Because the white man says, you know what? I know you hot. I know your people look up to you. So let's do this. I'm going to give you a cut. And you just put your name on it. And then we run out and spend $120 on a plain-ass white tee. Saying, oh, this is Kanye's tee. Kanye did it. Look at the label. $120 for a plain white tee. Meanwhile, we may continue to keep the white man rich. $120 for a t-shirt. $200, $300 for a pair of sneakers. Real.
And in want of all things.
In want of all things, right? So if you want to get married, you got to get a marriage certificate. You got to get a marriage license. If you got to drive, you need a learner's permit to learn how to drive. Permit is a piece of paper that says you have permission. You're asking permission. If you get stopped without a license, there's consequences for that. You didn't ask master for permission to drive. All right? You want to go to school, you got to go to their institutions that they control and learn the curriculum that they teach you. Even so-called prestigious black universities have to subscribe to the curriculum of the college boards and all of that, all right? They passing laws or attempted to pass laws in Arizona, in Alabama, in California, where they don't want to teach slavery anymore.
Yeah,
and you got to think about that. Now that you're learning that these things were assigned for us, and if they don't teach them, a lot of the younger generation don't know anything about the slave trade. They teach that less and less in school. Why? It's all crafty counsel to keep our people asleep, so we don't wake up and realize who we really are. Because the key to salvation is repenting as an Israelite man or woman. You can't go ahead and accept God and Christ as an African-American, as a Puerto Rican, as a Mexican. You have to first know your nationality, and then you gotta understand the laws. Read.
And he shall put a yoke of iron.
So it says, and he shall put a yoke of iron. Our enemy, there was a specific enemy that would put a yoke of iron. Go ahead.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he hath destroyed thee.
Did that not happen to our people in captivity? Did we not have yokes of iron upon our neck? Until he hath destroyed us as a people. So they Willie lynched us. Have you ever heard of Willie Lynch? There's a book, there's a little booklet out called Willie Lynch. Willie Lynch was a famous white slave owner, all right? And he was very successful at being a slave owner. And the other slave owners, he basically was one of the first motivational and public speakers to help people set up and run their plantations and their slaves the right way. And he's the one that taught about putting light skin against dark skin, putting the woman against the man, all right? And he put all that in us. That's why we're like crabs in a barrel. We think we're the enemy. That's why you have black on black crime. We kill each other. We sell drugs to each other. We destroy each other. All right? Thinking that we separate. I'm going to get mine. They're doing all of that. We've been Willie Lynch. We were destroyed as a people. And he talks about that if you instill these doctrines into the slaves, you will keep them enslaved for over 400 years. You won't even have to put chains on them anymore. Because they'll be so reliant on you and so against each other that you won't control them completely. We do the most menial jobs. We do the basis jobs, okay? Again, a handful of us may come up and may do certain things, all right? But it don't roll that way. Give me verse 32.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Did that not happen in captivity to our people? Did they not come and take our sons and daughters and take them away captive? Jump to verse 41.
Verse 41. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them.
Why wouldn't we enjoy them? We would have children and we wouldn't enjoy them. Go ahead.
For they shall go into captivity.
Because they will go into captivity. Go ahead. All right, because they will go into captivity, in slavery that's talking about. Now, again, remember, I said these were signs, okay? Give me verse 37.
Verse 37. And thou shalt become an astonishment.
It says that the Israelites will become an astonishment. Go ahead.
A proverb and a byword.
A proverb. Do you know what a proverb is? Explain to me what a proverb is. Okay, yes, it's a verse in the Bible, but a proverb, it's like a true saying, okay? Or like a stereotype, okay? A proverb, in easier terms, is a stereotype, okay? What are some stereotypes that they have for our people, all right?
Hispanics, slaves, the African-Americans eat chicken and watermelon.
Uh-huh, all right? But some of them are true, right? We subscribe to them. I'll give you another one. Listen, what's the difference between a black man and a pizza pie? anytime we're able to dress up when we're in court or locked up. There's plenty of them, all right? Go ahead, continue.
Among all nations. All
right, it says we will be a proverb and a byword among all nations, all right? What are some bywords, all right? Think, spit, cool, wetback, monkeys, all right? Those are the names that they call us. It says among all nations. All nations have a word, a derogatory term for our people. In all languages they have that. Go ahead.
Whither the Lord shall lead thee.
Wherever we are in the world, they have a word for us, okay? You know what else is a byword? African American. Anything being called something outside of what you are is a byword. A Dominican, a Mexican, all right? Simeon is the real tribe, not Dominican, all right? Puerto Rican. Puerto Rican means rich poor, all right? That's a mockery because they took all the riches from Puerto Rico. There's no riches in Puerto Rico, all right? And how can you be a thing if you're Puerto Rican? How are you a rich boy? Dominican means loyal dogs of God. And people run with that. And they subscribe to that. I already told you what African American means. All right? We have real godly names that have meaning in them. All right? Those are what our names are. Give me verse 68.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
So now Moses said, the Lord is going to bring you Israelites into Egypt again with ships. Do you know the history of the Israelites, how they were held captive in Egypt? You ever see the Ten Commandments movie and all of that, okay? All right, even though those aren't our people, the way they put them, they're all white actors and Moses' wife, okay? It says that he will take you into Egypt again. Now, if you know the Bible, they never went into Egypt again, right? Our people, the Israelites at that time, never went into Egypt again. So you got to think, what is that speaking about? You got that in Exodus 22?
Exodus chapter 20, verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Egypt means the house of bondage. Egypt is a Greek word for bondage. Go back to verse 68.
Verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Again? Okay.
With ships.
Into bondage again with ships. Where's the slave trade one? Where's the slave trade sign? Is it on the back of one of these signs? Pull that up. Get that for me, all right? Might be on the other one. It says that we will be brought into Egypt again. Yeah, that's it, all right? With ships, okay? The slave trade was Bible prophecy system. The transatlantic slave trade, okay? The Indian slave trade, all right? The Spanish slave trade. That's Bible prophecy. Moses, 2,000 years ago, said you will go into bondage again with ships. The most famous captivity known of with ships is the transatlantic slave trade, all right? That happened to your people, okay? The tribe of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, all right? With ships. Go ahead, continue.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee.
That's exactly like I'm telling you all these things. That's exactly how it's going to happen to you. Go ahead.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
We won't see Jerusalem. We won't see the promised land anymore again as a people. Go ahead.
And there,
in this place that these slave ships are going to take you to, go ahead.
Ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
It said you will be sold unto your enemies in auction blocks, all right? Just like you see here, all right? They will come off the ship in auction blocks. Wall Street was one of the biggest slave markets, the first commodity that was traded on the stock market, all right? It was built around slavery. Negroes for sale. You have signs that show Indians for sale. Read.
For bond men.
For slave men.
And bond women.
And slave women. Go ahead.
And no man shall buy you.
But no man shall buy you is dealing with an old Quaker word, meaning no man shall save us. Malcolm X couldn't save us. Martin Luther King couldn't save us. Marcus Garvey couldn't save us. The Young Lords, the Brown Berets, the Black Panthers, none of them could save us because they weren't dealing with the commandments of the Most High God.
That's
remember,
right.
All these things came upon our people because we were not keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments of God. And we will never unite as a people and never come up out of this captivity that we're in unless we return to the Most High God as Israelites and start to keep his commandments.
That's right.
Now, I know you're looking at your watch and everything. I'm sure that you got to be somewhere. But I want to show you. All right. Okay. All right. So I need to show you something before you go because part of repentance, all right, it's good that you learn this and that you know who you are according to the Bible. But you got to understand something. Remember, we didn't keep the laws and that's why these things happen. So if you want blessings back in your life, you want Christ to return, to finally take us up out of this and give us the abundance of all things, we got to start keeping the commandments. So I'm going to show you a commandment, all right? You know what I want, Deuteronomy 22:5, all right? That we're supposed to keep in the Bible, all right? Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Continue.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment. For all they that do so are abomination.
Okay, now read the part about the man. Usually I start with that.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So what's a woman's garment? Right? A dress. So that's real easy, right? Now read the first part.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Okay, so what pertaineth unto a man that woman wears? Baggy clothes? What pertaineth unto a man that women wear? What's a man's garment that women wear?
Boxers.
Chains, sister.
Pants.
If you go to the bathroom, right? If you go to the bathroom and you see the signs in the bathroom, if you can't read it, how do you know you're going into the woman's room? What's the figure? The figurine shows a skirt or a dress, right? You ever heard that word you say, I know she wears the pants in the bathroom, right? Why? Because pants are for men. The Bible shows you that pants are for men. That's not for women. If you saw a man walking by in a skirt, now in this day and age, it's hard to ask that question because that's somewhat acceptable. But under normal circumstances, all right? If you saw a man walking by in a dress or a skirt, what you would think that looks funny to you, right? There's something wrong with that. So why are we so accepting of women wearing pants? Alright? God says that's a sin. Now you didn't know that. Remember what I said? It's not here to condemn you, but we here to show our people. And we gotta show you what you don't know as part of your steps to repentance, to obtain salvation. Alright? That's part of the commandments that are here. Give me Leviticus 18. Alright? It's another law. I'm just gonna bring these laws out. They may or may not apply to you, all right?
Hey, man, so according to this tribe from Zebulon, I was brought up in the world.
I'm going to get into that. I'm going to show you how you got to this side of the world. Read that real quick.
Leviticus chapter 18, verse 22. Thou shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind.
All right, so God saying homosexuality is a sin. The Bible says that that's a sin. If a man lies down with another man, like he lied with a woman, that's a sin. And that likewise goes for a woman, all right? It's the same thing. So homosexuality is a sin. Those are sins that we are not supposed to do. You gotta repent from those things so that we can return back to the Most High God, all right? And you know that verse?
It is abomination.
And it is an abomination, okay? Now, give me Revelation 21 and 8, and then I'm gonna deal with your question, all right? Because you may say, okay, it's an abomination, all right? So what's the consequence for that thing, okay? It's abominable. Do you understand what abomination means?
Abomination.
All right? Like, if you smell vomit, right, it makes you want to vomit too, right? It's gross. It's abominable. Whatever you think is the most disgusting to you, that's abomination. So God says that a woman wearing pants or a homosexual, whether it be a lesbian or homosexual, those things, okay, are abominable to you. And there's a judgment for those things. You can live this life and you think you're not going to be judged. That's why we do things, right? The less you're punished, the more you continue on doing this. Because you start this way, oh, I got away with that. You start this way, oh, I got away with that. Thinking that judgment's not going to come. Read that.
Revelation chapter 21, verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving.
And unbelieving, all right? So you got Israelites that if they don't believe, okay, they're also in this group, okay? Go ahead.
And the abominable.
And the abominable, right? Just like abomination, the abominable. Women in pants, homosexuals, all right? Men wearing dresses, go ahead.
And murderers.
And murderers.
And whoremongers.
And whoremongers, all right? Adultery, fornication, whoremongers, go ahead.
And sorcerers.
Anybody dealing with witchcraft, brujeria, santeria, all right? Or Wicca, whatever you want to call it. Sorcerers, go ahead.
And idolaters.
Idolaters, all right? Bow down to false images, all right? And idolatry is much deeper than that. It doesn't necessarily mean you got to pray to something. There's a lot of things that can become your idol. Go ahead.
And all liars.
And all liars. Go ahead.
Shall have their part in the lake.
Their part in the lake.
Which burneth with fire.
Which burneth with fire. Go ahead.
And brimstone.
And brimstone. Go ahead.
Which is the second death.
See, we think that you're just going to die and that's the end of it. You have a spirit. You have a soul. That second death, all right, is talking about the destruction of your soul. You've done it. God is going to make sure that you suffer for what you did by thermonuclear destruction, okay? That's how it's going to go down, all right? And you're, listen, people who get burned with fire, right, real severe burn, they're not going to see that. All right, sister, you got a flyer and stuff like that?
Yeah,
we got classes online. You can watch us and check us out. There's a lot more information, all right? I pray we even do that, all right? When you get, I'm going to get right to your question now. When you get touched with fire, those people are never the same again. There's something spiritual about fire, right? Fire's weird. You know, they try to explain it. They question this, that, and the other. There's something mystical about fire. Thermonuclear heat burns your spirit. People who get burned are not the same. It touches you in a way that you can't describe unless you've probably gone through it, all right? So the lake of fire, people think, all right, so I'm going to live how I want to live, and I'm one and done, and that's it, and I'm all right. But they don't know that they got the second death that they're going to deal with. Now, you said you acknowledge to hear that we have written down that you're from the tribe of Zebulun. So before I answer your question, give me 2 Kings 13:14, all right? Do you know how your people came inside the world? You don't, right? Do you understand any history around that? Do they teach that? What do they say? Yeah, right? So you might hear something about folks and things like that, right? So I'm going to show you that the Bible prophesizes about how the so-called northern kingdom of Israel, okay? You read the history of Israel, you had a northern and a southern kingdom. The southern kingdom was the first three tribes, okay? The north, that's the southern kingdom, the first three tribes. The Northern Kingdom are all the so-called Latin tribes and the Native Americans. The Bible talks about how they came to this side of the world. All right? Read that.
2 Ezra, chapter 13, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners.
There were 10 at that time because you had the tribe of Dan, that the Bible speaks of. But then Dan was prophesied to be absorbed into the other tribe. So that's why now you have the 9 and then the 3. All right? So that's what it's dealing with. Okay? The 10 tribes. Go ahead.
Out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king.
All right, so out of the time of Hosea the king, they were taken out of their own land. Go ahead. When was the Assyrian capital? 722.
Yeah.
Right, BC. 722
BC. Okay, go ahead. Boom, Salmaneser, the king of Assyria.
So Salmaneser, the king of Assyria, okay, under the Assyrian captivity, all right, go ahead.
Led away captive.
He led them away captive. Because the Assyrians' custom when they took over a land was to take the people out of that land and then put their people there. As a matter of fact, all these nations, okay, that have conquered and lived by conquering, that was their MO. They would take the people that were there and move them out and then take those names and those places and say that they were them, okay?
So did the Jews.
So did the so-called Europeans.
That's exactly what the Jews did.
All right?
That's exactly.
And he carries them over the waters.
That's exactly
and
what
so came they into another land.
That's exactly what the fake Jews did.
No, that's what the Jews did.
Right?
That's exactly what they did. They slaughtered and killed
every
tribe that did not conform to their ideal.
So it says that they took this council.
Oh, come on. Come on, look at me. Look at me. Look at me, buddy. Look at me. Look at me.
Under Hosea the king. God put it on his spirit to release
no,
the Israelites.
No, God slaughtered everybody under the auspices of the Jews.
Among yourself, all right?
Come on.
Right? You're exactly right. Those people who you know as Jews today are not the Jews, all right?
What I'm saying is,
okay?
If you look back at the Old Testament, the Jews slaughtered everybody that got in their way.
Oh, yes, they did, exactly. And that's what's going to happen again. Go ahead.
Well, then how is that right? Is it okay? Why is thermonuclear war any worse than what?
Was it okay when your forefathers took our foremothers and raped them? And
by the way,
when they took our babies and smashed them against the rocks, was that okay?
Sir,
let me ask. Was that okay?
Sir,
was that okay?
Sir,
was that okay?
May I ask you a question?
It's a yes or no question. No, you cannot ask me a question until you answer a question of mine. Was that okay when your people did that to our people?
It did not happen because my people did not get here until the 1900s. It did not happen. Oh, you are full of shit. My people did not get here until 1900. So you cannot lay slavery on my doorstep.
Who's your people?
Hungarians? Italians?
Oh, Italians didn't have slaves? The Romans did not have a slave society?
The Jews didn't have slaves?
Listen,
the Jews did have slaves.
Was it right what your people did to the Israelites, to our people? Was it right? Yes or no?
They don't know.
Yes or no?
My
you
people.
You can't even bring yourself to say.
My people
that's
did not do that.
That's how wicked you are.
My people did not do that. My people were poor Italians, Hungarians, Polish, Croatians. That is not true. That is not true.
Are you filming this?
That is not true. That is not true. That is not true. That is not what happened. That is not what happened. That is not what happened. You are wrong. Sir, you are casting false aspersions. You are lying. You are lying. You are casting false witness upon your neighbor. You are casting false witness upon your neighbor.
Verse 9.
Revelation, this is what God says is in store for the so-called white man. Read that. Any man have an ear, let him hear. Any of you that have an ear.
Is that just not racist?
Go ahead.
Is that not racist?
Hold on.
Is that not
racist? You know what racist means? Racist means you're for your people.
You just said.
I am racist. Because I am for the blacks, Hispanics, and Natives.
That's right!
And God is amazing! Because God is only for the nation of Israel. He was going to have it. He was going to have it.
He that leadeth into captivity.
He that leadeth into captivity.
Shall go into captivity.
They let our people into captivity. They will go into captivity. That is our salvation. That is our promise in Christ, the Black Messiah. Read.
He that killed with the sword.
Because we were killed with the sword and worse. Go ahead.
Must be killed with the sword.
So we're going to do it to his people again. Go ahead.
Here is the patience and the faith of the saints.
Now, does that mean we're going to go out and revolt today? No, that's madness, all right? We can never rise up against this power. We can never rise up against this society the way we're fractured and broken down, all right? It says that is our patience. That is the patience of the saints. Because when Christ returns and drops these walls and destroys Babylon the Great, which is America today, this place will be decimated. And when they go and they hide in their bunkers, in their shelters, God is going to put the spirit on the Israelites, the blacks, Hispanic, and Native Americans, to hunt them down and do what was done to us. That is only right, because God is a just God. They will not go unpunished.
Where is God when God's people dying of starvation in Africa?
Yeah, because we're dying because we're wicked as hell. We don't keep the commandments, all right?
There is no God.
Go back. Go back.
People don't walk along
with
you.
So let me listen. Let me bring this out. Let me bring this out.
Educate this brother.
This is how the so-called Hispanics and Native Americans got to this side of the world. All right? The Bible prophesied about this thing. Read that.
Second Ezra, chapter 13, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes.
The 10 tribes, at that time there were 10. There was the tribe of Dan, which was prophesied to be absorbed into the other tribe. The 10 tribes start with Ephraim all the way down. Go ahead.
Which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king.
So under the Assyrian captivity, they were carried away out of their own land. And I explained that the Assyrian custom was to remove people from their land and put their people there. Europeans, so-called Europeans, the white man that's over there, that's not even his land. The white man never had any land, according to God.
He does crawl around in caves.
All right? They were dark-skinned people in over there. And they went and they took them. The original Greeks were black. All that land was originally black.
They didn't even know how to cook their own
They
food.
Were not Israel, but they were black, okay? Right. And they went in because that's what the white man does. Historically, they conquer. And the Bible talks about that. They live by the sword. Nothing is there. They didn't invent anything. They didn't come up with anything.
They take
everything right. by right. blood. Just like they did to the Native Americans.
That's right.
And
right?
rock and roll.
Read that.
Boom. So Manasseh, the king of Assyria, led away captive. And he carried them over the waters. And so came them into another land.
So they came into Nineveh, all right, into Assyria as slaves. Go ahead.
But they took this counsel among themselves.
Now what happened was, is that Cyrus, the king of Persia, came up as a world power. And the Bible tells you God put it on Cyrus' heart when the Persians took over.